student that took that picture, Hannah Waters, joins me now. Hannah, thank you for being here. And thank you for taking that photograph that we're able to see, because people don't have a real clear image of what's really happening in these schools right now. And so, Hannah, you know, you went to school. You, of course, you saw the crowds in the halls. You saw there were a lot of masks. You took the picture. Hannah, why did you choose, or why did you want to post this image?
I took the photo initially after seeing the first day of school photo taken by someone else go online as well and got picked up by some media coverage. And I took it out of mostly concern and nervousness after seeing the first days of school.
So what were you so concerned and nervous about?
I was concerned for the safety of everyone in that building and everyone in the county, because precautions that the CDC and guidelines that the CDC has been telling us for months now weren't being followed.
And Hannah, what is shocking to a lot of people is that here you are, you're a sophomore now, right? And you've been suspended. And why? The school told you that you had violated the code of conduct for using your phone and posting to social media, but you say you didn't violate the rules. Why not?
I violated three of the code of conduct policies. One of them saying that I use my phone during instruction time and that I use it in the hallway during class change. But it also says that students 9 through 12 have permission to use it. The second one that they said I broke was using my phone during school hours for social media. But I posted the photo onto Twitter after school during dismissal, at the end of dismissal. And then the fourth one I did break. It was the one about filming students and posting it on social media platforms.
Do you regret doing any of this?
I'd like to say that this is some good and necessary trouble, so I don't regret posting this, because it needed to be said.
Good trouble is a good thing, they say. CNN has also reached out to your school, by the way, Hannah, but we haven't heard back. But the superintendent did send out that message to families, and they said that the photo is just out of context and that students are only in the hallway for a really brief amount of time. Does that line up with what you've seen? Is it really that brief of an amount of time that these kids are passing, that your classmates and student body are passing each other like that?
We have about 5 minutes to go through class change. Some of us go from all the way in the front of the building to the second floor to the opposite side of the campus. So those 5 minutes we spend like speed walking all the way to class, and we pass so many people in the hallway. We pass people who are seniors, we pass freshmen, we pass teachers, we pass staff, we pass everyone in that building.
So have you seen a lot of cases of teens like yourself who are contracting or spreading the virus? I mean, what's your biggest fear if you got infected?
I've seen a few of my friends or fellow classmates that have told me or said online that they are being tested or that their family member has been positive. So, and obviously these types of things, you really, it takes a while to figure out if you've gotten it. So my biggest concern, it's not only about me being safe, it's about everyone being safe, because people behind every teacher, student, and staff member, there's a family, there's friends, and I would just want to keep everyone safe.
Sounds like you know precisely what good trouble is.